next lesson, that is lesson number 6, our environment. So, in our class, we are going to learn about our environment. Actually, what is environment? The place around us, all the living and non-living things which are included together is called our environment. The way we live, to the our surroundings totally together, we call it our environment. Still, let's open page number 41 in our textbooks. Our environment. Our surroundings, including all living and non-living things, make up our environment. Plants, animals, and humans are called living things. Air, water, and salt are called non-living things. See, I told you already. What is environment? Our surroundings, including all the living and non-living things, make up our environment. First of all, what is living thing and non-living thing? Living things which breathe, which grow in size, which can move from one place to another place. Yes or no? And non-living things, they cannot breathe, they cannot move from one place to another place. They need someone's help to move from one place to another place. Such things are called non-living things. Living things, example, human beings. Non-living things, example, table, bench, chair. Yes? So, and you know, air, water, and soil are called non-living things. But plants and human beings are called living. Plants cannot move, but even though they are called as human beings, living things. Why? Because like human beings, even plants breathe air. So that's why. And they grow in size. Yes or no? So that's why they are called as living things. We should keep our environment clean, but some harmful substances enter the environment and make it impure or dirty. It is called pollution. So, actually we should keep our surroundings, we should keep our environment very clean. But some harmful substances are entering into the environment and they are making our environment very dirty. So that is called as pollution. Actually, what is pollution? The presence of harmful substances in the atmosphere. What is atmosphere? The air around us. The place we are living, our surroundings. If it is dirty, then pollution will be caused. So the presence of harmful substances in the environment is called as pollution. So pollution children is of four types: air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, and noise pollution. See here, you can see. Pollution is of four types: air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, and noise pollution. Now children, let us discuss about each of the pollution. First we discuss about air pollution. So air pollution is caused by, so what are the reasons for its cause children? Smoke, which is released by the vehicles. And also the smoke and dust given out by factories. Have you seen factories near your house? If you have, you can see black air, gas-like substance coming out of it. Yes or no? So smoke and dust, see here, coming out of the factories. And also when you burst fire crackers, they release some smoke, chemical smoke, right? Even that will pollute our air. Next, burning of garbage, all the waste things, what you do? You all correctly can burn it, right? So when you burn it also, smoke is released and air gets polluted. Air pollution can cause breathing problems like asthma. It is also harmful for plants and animals. So air pollution causes breathing problems like asthma. Asthma means, see, if you walk for some distance, then you can't walk more. You will lose your energy soon. And see, due to air pollution, breathing problems will come. And you know, it is also harmful for plants and animals. Now next, we'll see about water pollution. So, water pollution is caused by, so what are the reasons for water pollution? Children, bathing of animals and humans, washing clothes, passing urine and feces in water bodies, which destroy all the waste in the rivers, lakes and all. So what the farmers or cattle trading people do, they take their animals to the river and they give a bath for them in the rivers, right? So this will contaminate, which this will damage the water. It will make it impure. So bathing of animals, even humans, some people they go for swimming over there and they use some soap and it will spoil the water. So bathing of animals, humans, and also though these what they do, they take So land pollution can cause poisoning diseases of lung cancer and even death. So due to land pollution, we get some poisonous diseases like disease of lung and cancer, and also some it will lead to death. Next, we will discuss about noise pollution. So sound that is not pleasant to our ears is called sound. See, sound children, up to some limit we can hear it. If volume is more, can you hear? No, you will close your ears. Why? Because we can't hear it more, right? So sound that is not pleasant, which is more than the limit, it will cause noise pollution. Too much noise leads to noise pollution. Noise pollution is caused by, so what are the reasons behind the noise pollution, children? Sound of television, radio, and other appliances at home. So if you increase your TV volume, radio, and also some appliances which make sound at your home, like you have a woofers and all, right? So due to that noise. Next, sound of machines in factories. Some machines make a huge sound in factories, right? Even that cause sound pollution. Next, bursting of firecrackers. Yeah, firecrackers also make a lot of noise, yes? Next, use of loudspeakers in public places. So if you use loudspeakers in public places, it will disturb others, right? So this is also one kind of noise pollution. Next, honking of horn. Unnecessarily, some people, what they do? They continuously horn their vehicles, yes or no, in the traffic. So due to that also, when they honk their horns continuously, sound pollution is caused. So loud noise, if there is too much of loud noise, it can damage our ears. And also it can cause deafness. Deaf means no, you can't hear it further if you have deaf. Next, ways to save our environment. See, there were some measures to save our environment. What are that? We can save the environment in the following ways. See, plant more trees as a main energy. First thing what you should do, children, you should plant more trees because plants give you oxygen. It will also clean the air. So you must grow more plants. Next, throw waste in covered bins and not on the ground. So all the waste things where you should throw in the dustbin, but that dustbin should compulsory have a cover. Next, avoid the use of folding bags and instead use paper, jute or cloth bags. So what you should not use, polythene bags, covers and all you should not use, okay? Instead what you should use, instead of polythene bags, you should use paper, jute bags, paper bags and cloth bags. Next, say no to bursting of fireworks. On Diwali, most of you children like to burst your crackers, right? So what you should do, year-wise, you slowly reduce the bursting of crackers. Because if you burst crackers, our air is getting polluted and sound pollution is also caused, yes or no? So to reduce the pollution, what you should do? Say no to bursting of crackers. Next, you should save water. Each and every drop of our water is important. Next, do not discharge the waste in water bodies. So you should never throw the waste things in the water bodies. Water bodies means rivers, lakes and canals, okay? Next, conduct a regular pollution check of it. If you have own vehicle, that may be a scooter, bike, anything, you should take